opened in 1998, we're in one of the newest on-campus football stadiums in the country, Papa John's Cardinal Stadium. And now the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan, innovation that excites. We'll see how this game plays out as they get ready for the opening kickoff. And he got all of this one. Great kick. He's to the 20. Brought down at the 22-yard line. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. Taken down right around the 32-yard line. Fumble, loose ball. It's picked up by the quarterback. And he's tackled at the 29. They nearly gave that ball away.
But luckily that guy was paying attention to what was going on and was able to recover the football.
So the question here is whether or not his knee hit the ground before the ball came out. They're going to review this fumble, and I've got to tell you, I think he was down before the ball popped loose.
I don't know about this one, Brad. They called it a fumble on the field, and they need indisputable video evidence to overturn this call.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field is reversed.
Well, after seeing the replay, it was apparent that his knee was down before he lost the ball.
Yep. Those guys in the booth aren't perfect, but they got it right this time.
They'll bring him down around the 33-yard line. Wonderful play call to convert on third down.
I'll tell you what, he really wanted that first down. Good determination to get it.
Up the middle for a nice game. Fires out to his receiver, and he's shoved out of bounds at the 46.
Nice job of picking up the Mike linebacker blitz and hitting his man for the first down.
After a decent pickup. That
brings him second down. Mike two.
Looks left, intercepted. Big opening. He's at the 30. The 10. Touchdown, Cardinals.
Job here by the defender breaking on the ball and taking it to the house. Man, those pick sixes can really hurt an offense and have a lasting impact.
And he adds the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Let's see how the defense responds now, coming off that big play just a moment ago.
They just gave the defense a gift by handing them the lead with that last interception. And now they've got to play from behind.
Screen pass. He's got his halfback. And they make the stop at the 26-yard line. Tackle at about the 37-yard line.
They blitzed the corner that time, and it created a hole in the coverage. But that's the risk you take when you leave a receiver to rush the passer.
Tackle made
at about the 43-yard line.
And he's tackled after positive yardage.
That makes it first and 10.
Let's go!
Easy!
Slings it. He's tackled at the 46-yard line.
That brings him second and 5.
Got an opening. He's taken down
at about the 27-yard line.
That's another first down, Brad. And right now, you can just really feel and sense the rhythm that this offense is in. Their ability to pick up first downs, just pushing this defense further and further down, back deep into their own territory.
From the 27-yard line, first down. And a quick throw, brought down at the 16-yard line. First down.
Around the 5-yard line.
That makes it first and goal.
Right two.
Easy. And he's hit before he can go anywhere. And he's got his man. He flicked his wrist and made the connection to his wide receiver.
It looked to me that the defense was more worried about the quarterback scrambling, and that's why they just gave up that touchdown.
They'll line up for the extra point in an attempt to tie the game. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Jones is lined up to kick this one off. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
They've got to play with some focus and smarts here. They don't want to make a mistake and suddenly find themselves trailing.
Brown on the give. Gets to about the 27-yard line. From their own 27-yard line, it's second down.
Blue 19!
Scrambling around, and he's taken down at the 30-yard line. Scrambling, and they get the sack.
A defensive end with this kind of speed is an offense's worst nightmare. He's got the ability to collapse the pocket on any given pass play, and as a play caller, you constantly have to be aware of it. Whether you're going to roll away from him or you're going to chip with a tight end or a running back, you're constantly concerned and aware of a big, strong defensive end.
So no luck on that drive as they go three and out. Norwood is back deep to return. Norwood fields at the 29, and he's tackled at the 42.
I think we saw the effects of what a long drive can do to a defense the last time this offense was out on the field. They took that football and drove the length of the field to put points up on the board. I think it really started to affect not only just the psyche of this defense, but maybe even the conditioning, where they started to get a little bit fatigued. This wide receiver is very frustrated. You can tell by his body language. He did everything he needed to do to get open to be able to make a big play. The quarterback just didn't put the ball in the money.
Pressure and brought down. So the sack makes this third and very long. Into double coverage, and that's going to be picked off. And he's tackled at the 40-yard line. And the defense just picked up their second interception of the game.
This defense has really been in sync during the first half. If they keep this up, it'll be a long day for this offense.
He gets sacked on the play.
Called a loss of 4 yards on the play. That makes it second and 14.
They come up to the line here at second down and 14 after the sack.
Down! Okay!
And he just gets rid of it.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
Going deep, lays it out there, finds the junior, touchdown, big play. The wide receiver flew down the field on that touchdown connection.
Well, he has the speed to stretch the defense, and his hands are getting better every single game.
And doesn't it always seem like he just finds a way to get open? And he converts the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He's to the 20. And he makes it out to about the 21-yard line. Well, let's see if he can shake off that pick that he tossed last time out.
He can't dwell on the interception. There's still a whole lot of football to be played today.
Throwing right. Big gain there for the first down.
There was some miscommunication down there by the defense that allowed for that big gain.
Play action. He'll scramble. Second down and 12. Ball on the 47. He makes it out to midfield. And a great ball game so far as we reach the end of one. 14-7, Louisville. And we're ready for more football here in quarter number two. So an empty backfield with five wide receivers. And he's level at the 41-yard line. They'll line up with five wide receivers.
Let's go. Easy, easy. Big down. Big down.
incomplete. They got a hand on it.
It's a great job here by the defensive coordinator with this play call. A lot of times you start to maybe think about blitzing linebackers. This time he keeps the linebackers back in position to be able to knock the football away and not give this offense a chance to pick up the first down.
Got his man. Can't tack on any yardage. Defensive coordinator anticipating this five-wide set, and he comes in with his dime package.
This quarterback is tough as nails, Brad. He's going to sit in that pocket and give himself a chance. The only problem is, at some point, you've got to have a feel, almost that sixth sense on when to get out of there and avoid the pressure, or just to throw the ball before you get hit.
And he just drilled it from long range.
Great snap and a perfect hold, and he just had an awesome follow-through. Everything went right there on that long field goal.
14-10, Louisville. Baylor is lining up to kick this one off. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Louisville is up by four. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. They'll lose a yard on that quarterback keeper.
Call the loss of 1 yard. That'll bring up third and four.
Set, Texas.
Gets it. He's in space. They'll bring him down at the 38. Their own 38-yard line. First down. They go back to him on a quick throw. Good tackle there in space.
I'll tell you what, this defensive coordinator is not afraid to send the house. He brought every linebacker, and the quarterback was still able to convert the first down.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 45.
Set, Oklahoma!
Hey, we can kill it. Set.
And they make the stop, the 37-yard line. Pushed out of bounds at the 27-yard line. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 27. Louisville holds a 4-point lead. He gets rid of this one.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
And he tackles him hard at the 34.
As an offensive line, you've got to do a better job as a group in communicating. Defense brought pressure. And that time, they did not do a good job of picking up the linebackers. The linebacker was able to come up with a sack.
And now they're faced with another third and long as they try to convert and move those chains again. He throws it. That close to being intercepted. That could have been a big play for the defense.
Yeah, even though he had a good shot at picking it off, it's still a heck of a play to force the incomplete pass.
It's up, and he splits the uprights.
There it is.
Wallace has the ball all teed up, and he's ready to kick this one off. Sends it sailing downfield. He's to the 20. Gets to about the 24-yard line. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. And he hits him hard at the 41.
First down.
Picked off. From their own 41-yard line, second down. They come out in a five-wide set. Tackle at the 48-yard line. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts. Complete, brought down, nothing doing. That'll be a gain of 3 yards.
The freshman took the quick pass, but the defense made a very nice read on the play. He didn't have anywhere to go.
So it's fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. Oh, he had the pick, and he dropped it. Not quite enough for the first. Looks like they'll turn it over on downs.
You know what? I think they still made the right call there.
I can't argue the play call. The defense just did their job by standing their ground. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Louisville is up by a touchdown. Caught, and he's out of bounds. That's a loss.
That is a loss of 1 yard. That'll bring up second and 11.
From their own 48-yard line, second down. And he throws it away. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
Wants to go long and does. He's hit and taken down. The big pass play. We've got a first down.
Set. Hey.
Caught him, but they're going to lose yards. He was tackled immediately. That's a loss of about three.
They really just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated him there.
Once again, they'll come to the line trying to convert on third down.
Set.
And he might want it all here and does. Oh, my, what a catch. Touchdown. The PAT. So a six-play, 51-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
Brad, I love these kind of drives. They're old school, grind it out and earn the yards and just rip the heart right out of that defense.
They line up to kick this one away. And he got all of this one. Great kick. He's to the 20. And down he goes at the 29. They're set to go for another round. They spread the field in the gun with five wide receivers. And he is drilled at the 21.
Wow, that is a big hit on the quarterback. That's one of those, as an offensive lineman, when the film study starts to come around, you're going to kind of sink in your chair and just hope they don't call you out, because you're going to get embarrassed on Monday. You know?
Halfback's got it on the quick throw. Tackle made around the 39-yard line. He put the ball in there perfectly that time.
And let me tell you, this kid has impressed me all day with the touch on his passes. That's a good-looking throw there.
Here's the halfback on the screen. And down he goes around the 41-yard line. In the middle. He's taken down right around the 48-yard line. Good pitch and catch there on second down.
Yep, it was good enough to get him a first down. That's just a nice play.
From the 48-yard line, it's first down. Fires out to his wideout. He's tackled around the 38-yard line.
That'll make it 7 inches.
He's going to try and scramble. He's at the 30, and he's taken down around the 29-yard line.
98 Weasel! 98 Weasel! Here we go! Easy, easy, easy! Buffalo, Buffalo!
Catches it, and that's all.
98 Weasel! 98 Weasel!
He's tackled right away. Quick strike to the receiver. Brought down at the 15. So at the end of the half, the Cardinals lead 24-10.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Rhys Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half.
This has been the kind of first half that every pass rusher who's ever played the game just dreams of. It's been a free run at the quarterback. Now, I'm sitting here in the studio with you. We're watching all these games. I know that the strategy is going to change. I know they're going to keep extra guys in to block. They're going to keep running backs in. They're going to chip pass rushers. But the defense knows, too. What kind of impact does that have on a defensive player when he knows it's coming?
Well, it makes a huge impact, especially when you got defensive linemen that continue to come off the edge and make big plays, because that doesn't mean I have to blitz that guy. If you want to take a tight end and put him over to my defensive end, there is a thing called a zone blitz. It's not a new invention. You can drop that guy into pass coverage, bring heat off the other side. So I think the defense knows to change up their strategies, and they also know that the quarterback and the OC, offensive coordinator, they're going to go to a quicker passing game. They can sit on the shorter routes because they know the ball's coming out. When you got when you got pass rushers coming home like they have, cornerbacks get to be more aggressive. Safeties get to be more aggressive, and you can see them making bigger plays probably in the second half because of it.
That'll do it here in the studio at halftime. We'll try to see if Pollack can bring a little energy in the second half. Got a lot of games to watch, including yours. Brad and Kirk, ready for the second half.
All right, Rhys, David, thanks, guys. Just about set to start the third quarter. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. They're ready to begin another drive. And he's tackled around the 27-yard line.
Call it a gain of 2 yards. That makes it second and eight.
From their own 27-yard line, it's second down. Nice run up the middle. work the right side, and there is nothing going there. Norwood is back deep to return the punt. Made a few guys miss on his way to a quality return. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Catches it, and he's immediately tackled behind the line. Loss of a yard.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
From their own 38-yard line, second down. Hit out of bounds around the 42-yard line. That's 4 yards on the play.
You know, little passes like this force the defense to start to come up. Then you can see an offense take their chances downfield later to take advantage of the defense starting to cheat up.
That's a great tackle at the 49-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
Tackled after a decent pickup. And they get nice yardage on that run. They'll bring him down at the 37. And he's tackled after positive yardage.
That'll make it second and four.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down. He's at the 20. Makes it out to about the 19. He makes his way out to about the 9.
That's a deep 10. That'll make it 7 inches.
They get him in the backfield for a loss. And this is the 11th play of the current drive. Touchdown, Bears.
Execution by the entire offensive unit, especially the blocking up front.
That is exactly what they needed to get back into this game.
A defensive stop on this next possession, and this game could very well be tied going into the fourth quarter.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. Baylor gets set to kick this one away. Excellent kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. Louisville up 7 points. Quick pass, and he's level at the 34-yard line. Short yardage situation here. It's second down and 1.
a very impressive open field tackle. Hit before he can go anywhere. From the 47-yard line, it's second down. And he just gets rid of it. Stop around the 45-yard line. Looks like they're going to go for it on fourth down.
Set, down, cut.
He's going to be short. Football will change hands as they fail to convert on fourth down. They ran the ball very well on their last drive, and it resulted in six. He makes it to the 48-yard line.
That's a That makes it 7-6.
Run, and he's brought down. He has some room, and he tackles him hard at the 38-yard line.
Call it a gain of 8 yards. First down.
Watch two.
His left going the other way. He just jumped up and snatched that ball.
Well, there, I don't think the quarterback even saw him. The defender went up into the air and made a great catch.
From their own 26-yard line, first down. Louisville is up 7. And he's hit immediately. Brown takes it right side. They bring him down in the backfield.
We'll give the defense all the credit here. Hey, that one snuffed out from the start. It could have been an even bigger loss.
It's second and 11. Ball on the 41-yard line. Passes it to the middle of the field, and he hits him hard at the 42-yard line. End of the third, and we've got a tight one. 24-17, Louisville. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number four.
Down.
Throws it out there. Finds his receiver who's all alone. Tackle at about the 19-yard line.
This secondary better tighten it up. It's going to slow down this drive.
And the big pickup through the air has made it first and 10. To him again, complete. Nice play to set up first and goal.
Number 35 makes the tackle at the 6-yard line. That will be changed for the Louisville
Tampa score.
Set, Oklahoma.
Tackle made at the 3-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 3 yards. That brings up second and goal.
From the 3-yard line, second down. Defense stacked in tight here. A 2-yard run by the halfback.
That makes it third and goal.
We're at play number 9 of this current drive. They go with the toss. They'll wrestle him down in the backfield.
That brings us fourth and goal.
They're going to go for the easy 3 here. The kick is up, and it's through the uprights. Wallace has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. Sends it sailing downfield. He's to the 20. Tackle at the 33. Well, I'm sure the return man would have loved to go for 6 that time.
This is where you always hear that saying, the big-time players make big plays in big games. This is where somebody on this offense needs to step up and be that big-time player.
Here's the give. He fights forward to about the 36. The back gets 3 on the carry. He makes his way to about the 48.
Carries the ball. Gain of 12 yards.
First down. Choose the mic.
He makes his way to about the 38.
Gain of 14.
First down.
He's at the 30. He's at the 20. The 10. And he's finally taken down at the 6-yard line.
That makes it first and goal.
Side of the football. They know what this team likes to run, and they got the better of them that time.
It's third and goal, and they're about 4 yards out. Touchdown, Baylor!
It shouldn't have surprised these guys to see the run coming at them, but they just couldn't stop it.
Trying to get within a field goal. They'll try the point after. And he tacks on the extra point. Baylor ready to kick this one off. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Things aren't tied, but they might as well be. It's this drive that could really dictate the tone for the last quarter. Louisville has a 3-point lead. Caught it, but they're going to lose yards. He was tackled immediately. 2-yard loss.
Not much going on there. Those kind of plays will not work against this defense. You can be sure of that.
It's second and 12. Ball on the 23.
Set. 10 Boston. 10 Boston.
He's taken down right around the 26-yard line. From their own 26-yard line, third down. Taken down at the 11. Defense just came up with a huge interception. That might be the biggest play of the game. From the 11-yard line, it's first down. Just under two to go in the game. And he converts the extra point. They line up to kick this one away. He really got a hold of that kick. Louisville's coaches have got to be confident in the fact that they've got a star player in a tight situation.
And there's nothing better than having a quarterback you have confidence in these kind of situations. You know he's going to make the right read. He's going to give his receivers a chance to make a play on the ball. They're going to have a really good chance of moving the ball down the field to have a shot to win this game.
Lost the ball. Fumble. Now the defense has it. The safety. And down he goes at the 34. That was a huge turnover.
Yeah, and it couldn't have come at a better time for this defense. You're trying to come up with a big stop, and now you get the ball back with the lead.
This is where the offense has to come to the forefront. They work all week for situations like this. They've got the lead, they've got a chance to add to it, and that'd mean a victory. He's at the 20. Gains his way to the 16-yard line. What a critical first down as time ticks away.
Huge, huge first down. The defense desperately needed a stop there.
Gets out to around the 6. He caught some key blocks and was able to turn it into a 10-yard gain. So it's second down, and they're only about a foot away from picking up the first down. Just over a minute in the fourth quarter. Touchdown, Bears. And he hits the PAT. With a three-play, 34-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result. Baylor lines up for the kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The offense couldn't hang on to the ball last time around. Let's see what happens here.
One general rule in any game is to hold on to the ball. If you're in the negative in the turnover department, your chances of winning decrease exponentially.
And he is drilled at the 17.
Loss of 8 yards on the play. That'll make it second and long.
And he stops the clock with a spike. From their own 17-yard line, it's third down. It's intercepted, and that should do it. And he's tackled around the 23-yard line. Boy, the defense was all over the ball in the air. They come away with a dagger of an interception. from the 23-yard line. First down. Nice run up the middle. He's carried this offense on his back, that's for sure. He's got 200 yards.
It's been a really potent running attack today, and it's revolved all around him and the plays he's made.
He'll go down to one knee. Offensive guns were ablaze all day, and it came down to who had one more shot. 38-27, Baylor. That does it for this edition of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.